Welcome back, everybody. We are on our second week of jazz. I hope you've been enjoying it so far. But before we get started, you should have just done your welcome song. And now we are going to do our brain break. So go ahead and stand up. Make sure that you have plenty of room. And here we go.
And the rhythm starts to play. Dance. When marimba rhythm starts to play, dance with me, make me sway. Like a lazy ocean hugs the shore, hold me close, sway me more. Like a flower bending in the breeze, bend with me, sway with thee. When we dance, you have a way with me, stay with me, sway with me. Other dancers may be on the floor, and here in my eyes we'll see only you. Only you have that magic technique. When we sway, I go weak. I can hear the sound of violins long before it begins. Make me thrillers, only you know how. Sway me smooth, sway me now. Other dancers may be on the floor, dear, but my eyes will see only you. Only you have that magic technique. When we sway, I go weak. I can hear the sound of violins long before it begins. Make me thrillers, only you know how. Swimming smooth, swimming now. When marimba rhythm starts to play, dance with me, make me sway. Like the lazy ocean hugs the shore, hold me close, swimming home. Like a flower bending in the breeze, bend with me, sway with thee. When we dance, you have a way.
All right, great job, guys. Go ahead and have a seat. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Put your hand over your heart. If you can still feel your heart racing, that means you need to breathe a little bit more. And if it's going super fast, we want a slow, steady heartbeat. So breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. All right, so we're going to do a jazz rhythm drill today, and you'll see something that you've maybe seen once or twice, but these are 16th notes, okay? And you can either do them as tiki-taka or avocado. Either one is fine. If you want to go tiki-taka or avocado, that's fine, but it's avocado. Can you do that with me? Ready, go. Avocado. Can you do tiki-taka? Ready, go. Tiki-taka. How about avocado? Ready, go. Avocado. So if you look at this first rhythm, it would be, I like avocado because I like food. So it would be ta, avocado, ta, shh. Can you do that with me? Say it with me. Ready, go. Ta, avocado, ta, shh. And the little X two means do it two times. So you're going to do it again. Ta, avocado, ta, shh. Then we're going to go down here. We have avocado, shh, ta, ta. Can you clap that? Ready, go. Avocado, sh, ta, ta. And you do that two times, okay? So don't let the avocados scare you. This is a little fast, but I think you can handle it. Here we go.
Mesdames et messieurs, j'ai l'honneur et le privilège de vous présenter le Big Band, qui nous vient de la cité du swing.
Be ready to beat the stars straight up in time. Shall like hairspray, put the things in his size, everybody's way.
Horny horners blow up the big band. Soprano trombones, alto saxophones. Without all the drums and kicks of his band, tell me what would be left of Duke Ellington. Big band in the big city. It's the big band. It's a big bang. Forget about all the fuss. Get out from the gang. The band phenomenon was born with Fletcher. There came the guys that jive where basically Miller. Without all the blowers swinging big band. Who would swing Calloway's mini boomer? Take away a mouse or sound the big band. What would Marilyn do with her oopsie-doo? Big band in the big city.
Great job. I hope you enjoyed that. I definitely did. And you probably just crushed those 16th notes. All right, your learning targets for today. By the end of the class, you should be able to say, I can recall information about our composer of the week, but we actually have two. We're going to have Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong. I can define jazz music. I can explain scat. I can identify the different jazz instruments. I can identify some of the jazz dances. I can keep a steady beat and clap the correct rhythms, and I can perform the correct movements to the songs and dances we learn. So we have an action-packed lesson today. All right, Ella Fitzgerald is one of our composers this week. She was born April 25th, 1917 in Newport News, Virginia, which was not far from where I grew up. And she passed away on June 15th, 1996. She was an American jazz singer and known for her ability to perform improvisation. And we talked about improv yesterday, where you make it up as you go. You get to be extra creative. So what Ella is most known for is scatting. And scatting is, it kind of sounds like gibberish, but you are kind of pretending to be an instrument. So, you know, if you're pretending to be a trumpet, you might be like, bur, 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 do, do, do. Or a trombone might be like, wah, 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 wah. So she's just using... well, really just nonsensical words, but she's doing it to mimic an instrument. So you're going to hear her saying scooty-doo-bop-beep-bop-a-doo-bop. That's scat, okay? And I'm going to skip a little bit, but she is amazing. She is the queen of scat.
Thank you so much. And, thought maybe this would fit in with the theme. Okay. All right. Shungdingy boom boom bing ding 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 ding
And I would let you listen to the whole thing because it is absolutely amazing. But we have so much to get to today. I cannot. But if you enjoy that, get your parents to, or family member, or whoever, to look up Ella Fitzgerald One Note Samba, and you can keep listening to her. She's got a bunch of songs, not scatting, that's absolutely amazing. I'm a huge fan of Ella Fitzgerald. So we're going to do something weird because you have two composers of the week. We're going to take a brain break in between. Because I've got a lot of information I'm throwing at you today, and I don't want you to get bored or be all wiggly. So go ahead and stand up. We're going to do another brain break.
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
I guess if you share sure, I'll have to pack my things and go.
That's right, hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
What you say?
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
Now, baby, listen, baby, don't you treat me this way.
All right. I hope you enjoyed that. Go ahead and have a seat. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your nose, and out through your mouth. Hopefully you have a slow, steady heartbeat. And we're going to keep on keeping on. Uh-oh, I am missing. I thought something skipped. All right. Somehow we got out of order here. Let me fix this. All right. So your other composer of the week is one of also my all-time favorites. I absolutely love jazz. I have always loved jazz, and I first started out playing trumpet and played in jazz band. So if you hear me say they're my favorite, they all are my absolute favorites, especially Louis Armstrong. I wanted to play trumpet just like him, just like Dizzy, just like Miles, and we'll study those other composers and musicians later. But Louis Armstrong, if you're a trumpet player, man, you want to play just like him. And he was born August 4th, 1901 in New Orleans. It looks like I did not put the date in for when he passed away, but he has passed away. He grew up in a very poor neighborhood. At the age of 12, he was sent away to a special boys' home for doing something he shouldn't have. And while he was there, he was given lessons on trumpet. So out of making a mistake, he made something good out of it. So if you make a mistake, it's not the end of the world. It just means we got to try something different. So while he was there, he was given a lesson on trumpet and fell in love with the instrument. I totally understand because I love that instrument as well. So here's Louis Armstrong. He's going to be playing his trumpet, but he also sings. And, you know, he's got a very unique voice, and he just seems like he's a happy guy.
And now, folks, here's a little number that I wrote myself. And Bobby Hackett and Peanuts Hucker and all the boys, they made recordings of this tune. And the title, Someday.
I'm gonna skip to him singing.
I treat you like a brother. Someday you'll be sorry, dear. Look at your mama. Someday you'll be sorry for most of the days. Papa don't say the way you treated me was wrong.
All right, I feel like I'm speed rushing through this, guys, and I apologize. We just have so much we have to cover. But you heard him scatting, just like Ella Fitzgerald. Scat is a huge part of jazz singing. So we're going to study some jazz instruments today, starting with my favorite, the trumpet, then the saxophone, piano, trombone, and drums. So I'm going to show you a little bit of my trumpet. This is a trumpet. It's a member of the brass family. It is, I don't know if you can hear it, made of metal. It has a bell. All brass instruments have some form of a bell, whether big or small. It has tuning slides that you can pull in. Well, guys, I'm going to turn your volume up because I'm afraid that that's super soft. I've got it as loud as I can. I got it on 80 or 92. So, okay, hopefully it doesn't start over. Yeah, of course
it has a bell. All brass instruments have some form of a bell, whether big or small. It has tuning slides that you can pull in and out to put them in tune. These are spit valves. Kind of gross, but it's not really spit, it's condensation. Then you have the valves that you push down to change the notes or the pitches. You have a mouthpiece. All brass instruments have a mouthpiece. And to play on the mouthpiece, I'm going to teach you. Say, mm. Can you do that? Mm. Right? And it's kind of silly and it kind of tickles. So I want you to make a really slow motorboat. Can you go? Great. Now we're going to make our motorboat go a little faster. Try not to spit all over the place. Right, now we're going to make our motorboat go into hyperspeed. Ready? Excellent. So that's how you have to buzz. On here, you say, mm, and you hyperspeed motorboat. So here is our mouthpiece. So when we put it in here, it actually makes a sound. All right. So in jazz, trumpets are used a lot. Sometimes they play really, really high and they scream. I'm not good at screaming. I wish I was. Sometimes they just play some fun jazz scales. Sometimes they just get to play cool little riffs, okay? Sometimes they'll use their hands to change the sound and make a wah-wah. Sometimes they get to use mutes. I don't have a mute with me, but you stick a mute into the bell and it changes the sound. So this is the trumpet, a member of the brass family and also used in jazz a lot.
All right, whoop. So I'm going to show you just some trumpet screams because I knew somebody was going to be like, what's a trumpet scream? It's the most awesome thing ever. So I'm just going to show you a couple of them. So if that doesn't make you want to be a trumpet player, I don't know what's going to make you want to be a trumpet player, but that right there is just, I'm like over the top excited already. All right, so our next instrument is the saxophone.
This is the saxophone. Now, this one's a little tricky because it is made of metal, but it's in the woodwind family. And why is it in the woodwind family? Because it uses a reed. See that wood piece? All woodwinds except for flute use a reed, and that's how they make a sound. The way you make a sound on a saxophone or an instrument with a reed, you roll your lip in, I call it grandpa lip. Then you have Dracula teeth. So your bottom lip is rolled in like a grandpa, your top teeth come out like Dracula, and then you pull your lips together tight like a drawstring bag. And that vibrating sound is what plays through here. So, if we put the saxophone together, which is a woodwind because we said of the reed, and my saxophone is having some issues, so it may not play for us. Let me see here. Okay. So that's a saxophone, and you push down the keys. It has a bell too, but it's a little different. It's not really a brass instrument. It's a woodwind instrument. And like I said, mine is having some pad sealing issues, so it's hard to play, but this is a saxophone, and it's used in jazz a lot.
All right, I'm going to show you somebody who's way better at the saxophone than I am, and their saxophone is in great working condition. His name is Kenny G. I have literally heard every single Kenny G CD at least 1,000 times because my parents absolutely loved Kenny G, and anytime we went on a road trip, I'm pretty sure I heard the same Kenny G CDs 1,000 times. So hopefully you'll enjoy him. This video is pretty old, But he's actually playing a tenor saxophone. What I was playing was an alto saxophone, but he plays it much better than I do, and his is working. So I wanted to show you some jazz dances. Now listen to me. You are not on Dancing with the Stars, and you are not a professional dancer. So I do not want to hear that you like hurt yourself or hurt somebody else trying to Lindy Hop. Let's leave the Lindy Hop to the professionals, guys, okay? But I do want to show you Lindy Hop, and I do want you to know that all the ladies have on bloomers, so when they do flips and stuff, it's just like a gymnast. They have something on that. It's not their, you know, undergarments. They have something on like a cheerleader. So, but Lindy Hop is an amazing form of dance that we are not going to do. I'm going to say that again. I don't want you trying to Lindy Hop. You can go take dance lessons with someone and learn how to safely Lindy Hop.
Hey, Pops, keep that beat a beatin'. I feel a rhythmic brainstorm coming on. One, two, keep that rhythm heatin'. One more rhythm like that and I'll be gone. Oh, man, don't stop now, we're jumping. Give everything to Lord now. This thing might turn into something. I ain't mistaken, here comes something now.
Care what you guys say, the swish and all those other silly dances, nothing beats that. I'm just saying, you might want to jump into some old time dancing, but not without lessons, because I don't want anybody to get hurt. All right, so the next instrument we're going to look at is the piano.
This is a piano. Pianos are used in jazz all the time, but pianos are also used in classical music, just like the other instruments. So what makes it jazz? It's the scales. A normal scale, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, it's not really very jazzy, but if we add in some flats and sharps, which we've talked about before, it makes it jazzy. Add in a few chords. Thank you. the jazz piano, and it's used a lot too.
All right, So we're going to listen to a little bit of the Pink Panther, and Pink Panther is very jazzy as well. Again, I know you're like, Miss Kaiser, come on. I'm loving listening to this. I apologize, but we just have so much to get through. So that's the jazz piano. And I'm hoping that you're watching some of these instruments and you're saying, yes, that, Miss Kaiser, that's what I want to play when I get to middle school. And I hope that is true for you. So this is the trombone, and it's a jazz trombone, and he is amazing. So that's the jazz trombone, if that's something that you're interested in. And the jazz drums are, this video made me want to go and just practice my drum set at home too. So, and I love that it's a girl. It doesn't matter if it's a boy or a girl, but girl power, I'm just saying, she is amazing as well. I'm going to stop it there because we've got one more thing I need to get to, but is she not amazing? Again, it makes me want to go practice my drums so that I can be that amazing. So the last form of dance, I showed you Lindy Hop. This is tap, and this is the Nicholson Brothers. They are also amazing. And again, please do not try to do any of the stuff that they're doing because they have been practiced and trained and you are not. So I don't want to get any phone calls that you broke your leg trying to tap dance. Okay. All right, I'm going to skip to a certain part because I want to make sure that we have time to get to it. All right, here we go.
Jump and jive. You got to take this mellow jive. Yes, yes. You take it on the mellow side. A boodily, boodily, boodily boy.
A boodily, boodily, boodily boy.
A boodily, boodily, boodily gay.
A boodily, boodily,
boodily gay. A boodily, boodily, boodily gay.
Now my legs hurt. I don't know about yours, but amazing, right? Again, I just think that maybe we should look at some of our dancing now and go backwards, because some jazz dancing is amazing. I wanted to do some Lindy Hop with you guys today. I mean, not some Lindy Hop, some Shim Sham, but we just won't have time for that. So I just want to go over your learning targets. By the end of class now, you should say, I can recall information about our composer of the week, Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong. I can define jazz music. I can explain scat. I can identify the different jazz instruments. We went over those today. I can identify some of the jazz dances. We definitely watch those. We're not going to do them because we don't want you to get hurt. I can keep a steady beat and clap the correct rhythms. I can perform the correct movements to the songs and dances we learned. Again, your assignment, as always, is to answer the exit ticket at the end of the learning path. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, and I hope you have enjoyed this, and hope you have a great week.